Hello friends, my name is Viren Singh. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the most awaited topic, that is reactor engineering. So let's see the reactor engineering and basic concept about the reactor engineering. Before discussing this chapter, first you have to learn about the growth kinetics. I have uploaded videos regarding growth kinetics and material balance earlier on my YouTube channel Smart Learning Academy. Growth kinetics, as I discussed, it follows the zero order and first order. Zero order in lag phase and first order in exponential phase. And what is material balance? That is mass in minus mass out plus rate of generation minus rate of consumption equal to accumulation of mass. What is the reactor? Reactor is the vessel in which a biological process is carried out. What is biological process? Conversion of substrate into product via cell mass or enzyme. Generally, three type of processes occurs in reactor engineering. The first one is batch, second one is semi-batch, and third one is continuous. In batch processes, the one-time feeding and one-time output is there. You can see here, there is no continuous feeding and no continuous output. Only one-time feeding at the beginning of the process and one-time extraction of the output at the end of process. Semi-batch processes can be divided into two processes. Either fed batch or product batch. Fed batch is continuous feeding but not continuous output extraction. It is used for the substrate inhibition processes, and in product batch processes, continuous product removal is there. Product batch processes is used for the product inhibition processes. Continuous process can be divided into two parts. Stirred tank reactor or plug flow reactor. When continuous process occurs in stirred tank, that is stirring or mixing is done by the stirrer or impeller, and in plug flow reactor, the mixing is done by the flow of air. It is fed batch and it is product batch. Continuous input is there. Intermittent is substrate is added after some interval time into the reactor and one time extraction of output. Product batch is one-time feeding at the beginning of the react process and continuous or intermittent extraction of the output. In continuous process, continuous input and output is there. Let's discuss the batch operation process. Batch reactor operation operates in closed system. Substrate is added at the beginning of process. Product removed only at the end of process. Generally used for the anaerobic process. Aerobic processes is not batch operation in strict sense. Like in aerobic process, you have to add air or oxygen after some interval of time. So it is not strictly a batch reactor process. Batch reactor is mainly dependent upon the conversion time. What is conversion time? That is it is time required to convert the substrate into product. Conversion time is also known as fermentation time, or it is also known as residence time in the CSTR or chemostat. In batch reactor operation, volume is constant. That is, one time feeding is here, beginning of the process. After fermentation time or conversion time, at the end of process, you have to remove the biomass or product. Let's discuss the fed batch reactor operation. As I told you earlier, in fed batch operation, that is fed batch. Fed is intermittent or continuous feeding of the nutrient. When there is substrate inhibition process or catabolite repression process, then fed batch reactor operation is required. Volume is not constant. You can see here, when you feeding the stream, the volume is continuously increasing. This is the condition at start, and this is the condition when the reactor is filled. After fermentation time or after residence time, the substrate is converted into biomass and product, and at the end of cycle you will harvest the product or biomass. It is also called semi-continuous condition or semi-continuous operation. A very important condition occurs in the fed batch operation, that is quasi steady state. You must remember the quasi steady state. What is quasi steady state? At this state, nutrient feed rate is equal to nutrient consumption rate. At quasi steady state, the dx by dt, change in the biomass concentration is equal to zero, change in the substrate concentration ds by dt is equal to 0 and change in the product concentration, that is dp by dt, is 0. Let's discuss the continuous operation. As the name suggests, continuous is continuous supplying of feed and continuous removal of the product or biomass, that is continuous input process and continuous output process is occurs. Continuous culture can be divided into two parts, chemostat and turbidostat. Chemostat, as you divide this term into two parts, chemo plus stat. What the stat means? Stat means static or constant. Chemo means chemical composition. That means chemostat is the system in which chemical composition or concentration of substrate, biomass or product kept constant. And in turbidostat, as the name suggests, turbido is turbidity, that is cell number, and stat means constant. Turbidostat is the condition in which turbidity or the cell number kept constant. Continuous culture can be divided into two parts as well. For the stirred tank reactor, that is CSTR, and for the plug flow reactor. In stirred tank reactor, the mixing is done by the impeller or stirrer, most commonly used reactor in various industries, and the plug flow reactor. It is generally used for the immobilized culture or enzymes. In stirred tank reactor, there is back mixing occurs, but in the plug flow reactor, no back mixing is there. I will tell you in detail about the back mixing in the plug flow reactor later. The plug flow reactor resembles to the batch reactor. In the continuous operation, it works on steady state approach. Steady state means the various parameters like biomass, substrate concentration and product concentration changes with the time is zero. That is dx by dt is zero, ds by dt is zero and dp by dt is zero. Let's see some differences between the chemostat and turbidostat. In chemostat, chemical environment kept constant. In turbidostat, turbidity kept constant. Monitoring is done by the concentration measurement in chemostat. Here, monitoring is done by the optical density. Constant condition maintained by limiting the concentration of limiting reagent. In turbidostat, constant condition is maintained by the controlling the flow rate. The environment in chemostat is static. And environment in turbidostat is dynamic, that is parameter is changes with the time. Volume is constant in the CSTR. There is one important parameter in the CSTR you must know, that is dilution rate. What is dilution rate? Is flow rate upon volume, or you can say 1 divided by tau. Here tau is residence time. In the batch operation, what we use the fermentation time or conversion time. And in the continuous reactor, we use the residence time. What is residence time? Residence time is how much time is required to convert the substrate into product in the continuous reactor. Or you can say the time required to stay in the reactor in continuous operation. Let's discuss steps to calculate material balances for biomass, substrate concentration, product concentration for any process like batch, continuous or fed batch process. Please remember these steps and learn these steps. It will help you to calculate the various formulas in batch operation, fed batch operation or continuous operation. First step is identify MI, mass input, mass output, rate of generation, rate of consumption and what is the total mass in the reactor. Second step, write the material balance equation for that process. Third is divide the whole equation by volume. Fourth is assume the steady state concept for fed batch. In fed batch, there is quasi steady state, and in continuous, there is steady state approach. That is dx or dx by dt, ds by dt or dp by dt is 0. And fifth step is manipulate equation to get the result, assumptions in CSTR or in fed batch system. So this is all about the basic of reactor engineering and basic concept about the batch, fed batch and continuous process and steps to calculate the material balance for biomass, substrate and product concentration. Please remember these steps. Please subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you very much.